Have you wanted to run better ads without spending hours designing them? Today, we're going to learn about an AI tool that can help you do just that. In fact, if you already have a website, you could generate ads and copy in just 10 minutes. Now, we've partnered with Semrush to bring you today's video. So to get the app, click on the card above or the link in the description below. Let's dive in. This Semrush app is called AdCreative.ai. And when you use it through Semrush, you get a substantial discount compared to using the app directly. To get started, click on Try It Free. You can log in with your existing Semrush account, or you can create a new account. After you log in, you'll see this screen. For your free trial, you'll need to provide your credit card information. Now, this is a 3-day trial, so make sure you make a decision in those 3 days. Once you've filled in your information, click Try It Now, and you'll end up on the AdCreative.ai app page. Step one of using this app properly is to set up your brand. And that's because elements of your brand show up all over your ads, whether it's your logo, your brand colors, or your products. Now, if you have a website already, the easiest way to get started is to tell AdCreative.ai about it. Kevin's not here, but as a representative of the Kevin Cookie Company, I'm going to make some ads for it today. When you paste your website URL inside of this text box, the AI goes to the site to read your logo, brand colors, and to get a snapshot of what you're all about. Now, it got our logo and our brand colors correct. You can see those in the preview on the right-hand side of the page. But the product description leaves a little bit to be desired. Fortunately, on our website, we have a good description of what we do. I'll copy it and add it to the product description back on adcreative.ai. Now, if you don't like what the AI has scanned from your website, you can always update the logo or your colors directly. You may have more advanced branding requirements too, such as a custom font or alternate logo. You can set those by clicking on the advanced setup header. You can choose from a large library of fonts or even upload your own. Now that we're done, I'm going to click on Create Brand so we can create our first ad project. Now, there are a lot of project types here, so let me take you through the most important ones. First up is the ad package. This gives you a set of images you can use for ads, as well as the ad copy. This package is a bundle of ad creatives, which are the images, and ad texts, which is the copy. If you have a product that you want to feature in an ad, use the product photo ads or even ad videos to make it more engaging. There are a few other types of projects, but let's keep moving forward. I'll click on ad package. Now, if you're not a marketer, this is usually the really painful point of ad creation, but AdCreative AI makes it easy. First, we need to explain our goal with this advertisement, as well as the product or service we're trying to advertise. Once again, you can scan your website directly for all of this information. It's better to scan a product-specific page instead of the homepage if you have one. In this case, I'm stuck with the homepage, so let's see what the AI figured out. These details will greatly influence the generated images and copy, so it's important to get them as accurate as possible. The first dropdown is the goal of the ad. Get sales is the right call. Next, we see the tone of the copy. Kevin's definitely a professional guy, but let's change the tone for this ad to be friendly. We do want this ad generated in English, but you can use it to generate ads in a number of different languages. The product name is not Kevin Cookies, so let's try chocolate chip cardamom cookies instead. It guessed the target audience was cookie lovers, I love that, and call to action is order now. I also like that. Finally, the description is decent. It's a rewritten version of the copy on our website. I'm satisfied with this, so I'm going to click next step to move on. Next up is choosing the ad strategy. By default, it's direct conversion. You'll use this one most of the time. The others are more promotional, limited time offer, buy one, get one free, free shipping, and so on. You can also write your own strategy, and if you don't like any of these, you can always click the Generate More Strategies button. This gives you more strategies tailored to your product and your brand. For example, now you have a flavor guarantee, a cookie subscription, or even a tasting event strategy. Direct conversion is still our game, so let's move on to the next step. Now we need to choose the size of the images that we want to create. AdCreative AI tries to make this simple by asking what platform you want to post on. When you select a platform, you see the recommended size changes. But as someone who's spent a lot of time on Instagram, I know you need to optimize for screen real estate. So instead of a square post, I'll choose a portrait post. Okay, we are now 3 out of 5 steps done, and the next step is to choose a background image. This image will be the main focal point of your ad, and you have 4 ways to find one. It could be auto-detected from your website. The AI, though, could not find any images, so we're on our own here. Clicking back into this, you can also see you can upload your own image. When you scroll down, you can see the third option, which is choosing a free stock photo. Let's search for cookies and see what they've got available. There are quite a few good ones in here, but my favorite is these cookies in a basket. Just in case you don't find what you're looking for, you can also browse paid stock photos. And what's cool is that as a paid user of the app, you don't have to pay for these photos. But I've got my photo now, so on to step number 5. This is likely where you'll spend the most time, because this step is the text on the image. Now I'm looking at this headline and this punchline, and it's not really our style. Now you can modify this text directly, but where's the fun in that? On the right-hand side of each of these text fields is a brain icon. First, I'll zoom out. Then I'll show you that when you click on it, you can change the text in a number of different ways. When you need more options to choose from, click on Suggest Variation. This might give you some ideas, but in my opinion, this is not where we're looking for magic from the AI. You need to think about what the punchline is. Before you resort to manual effort, however, you can try one other option, which is clicking on Change Sentiment. Let's see what happens if we change this to persuasive. This isn't quite it still. Let's try one more time. Taste pure cookie ecstasy? Let me know in the comments if that would get you to click this ad. I talked with Kevin and we want to highlight our cookie baskets. Now you see this preview on the right-hand side? Don't get caught up in the visuals here. This preview just shows you an example of how all this text and your background image can be arranged. At this point, we're ready to go, all the way down to the cookie call to action icon. I'm going to name this project, and I recommend that you do too. It makes it easier to keep track of what you're making. After those 5 steps, let's click Generate. Now, it's going to take a few minutes to generate a number of different advertisement options, so I will see you when it's done. Now this is the real magic. We literally have hundreds of different options to choose from. Now each of these images has a conversion score in the top left. This is a proprietary model that evaluates how a particular ad might convert relative to others. Now if you see a design you like, you can download it directly to your computer. Keep in mind, though, that you have a limited number of downloads available each month. You get 100 downloads per month by default. You also have a few other options, so let's scroll back up to the top to see them. Let's say you generally like an image, but you want to tweak it in some way. When you click the edit link under a post, you get 2 options, a quick edit and a Creative Studio edit. Let's try a quick edit first. With a quick edit, you can change any of the text, the background image, the logo, colors, or the font. And the changes only apply to the ad piece that you're editing. So let's say you don't like the colors on this one. You can select either of the colors, I'll select main color 1, and you can change it to anything you like. So let's try this orange. And then I'll do the same thing with main color too. Instead of this blue, let's go with a dark purple. Once you've completed your edits, click the Save and Render button to re-render this ad. The purple now shows up in the headline and the action text, and the orange is for the punchline and the cookie basket border. Now, what if you want to make more extensive edits, like adding or removing elements from the ad piece? Let's try that with creative number one. I'll click on the Edit button and then Creative Studio Editor to launch a more advanced editing experience. On the right-hand side of the editor, you'll see every element or layer which makes up this composition. I want to get rid of this cookie basket image and this white rectangle. So I can just click on either one of them to select them. I've selected the rectangle here, and while there are a lot of properties I can change about it, I just like to delete it. You can do that by clicking on the trash can in the top toolbar. I'd also prefer the background cookie basket to the foreground one. That means this one disappears as well, and I can delete it with the backspace or delete key. I've also been thinking about this punchline, and I'd like to change it here. You can double click on any text to edit it, and then I'll replace this with what I think is a better punchline. We'll make it left aligned instead of justified, and then we'll reduce the font size until it fits in two lines. Other edits that you can make include adding your own shapes, uploading your own images or stock photography, and moving elements around. To save your changes, click on Close Editor and then Save Changes. This adds the new creative to a new panel called Creative Studio Edited Creatives. The original creative is still available down below. As you browse through the list of creatives, you can check the ones that you like. Once you've got the variants that you like, scroll back to the top until you can see the AI-generated ad package header. Your next step is to download these, and when you click on the download button, you can choose to download all of them or just download the selected ones. And remember, these downloads count against your download credits for the month, so use them wisely. You can also connect directly to Meta Ads, Google Ads, or LinkedIn Ads to push your creatives and your copy. I'll go ahead and download these so you can see them without the watermark. While that's working, check out this Convert To button. With this, you can change the size of your selected creatives. But beware, you'll exit out of this project and start a new one. That's not what we want to do right now, so let's click on the Cancel button to get out of here. In the meantime, those images have finished downloading, so this is what they look like. The creative is just one piece of the puzzle. Remember, we still need the ad copy. So let's get out of here and then go back to Ad Creative. We're done with the creative section. Now let's move on to texts. There are a lot of ways to write good copy, and there are a lot of ways to write bad copy. Remember when you put a product description together earlier? Well, the AI has taken that and adapted it using several ad copy frameworks. For example, the before-after bridge formula or the pain-agitate-solution formula. Now, AI copy usually isn't perfect, so expect to make some tweaks, but it's a whole lot better than staring at a blank slate. And if you don't like any of the copy given here, you can always click the Generate More button to get more. Now, with any of these pieces of copy, you can choose to delete them using the trash can icon. And yes, I can't see anyone reading that eyesore of a paragraph. You can also edit the copy using the pencil icon or copy it for use in your ad manager. There is one more piece of this that we'll cover briefly, and that's the audiences button. Audiences used to be very useful for online targeting. Specifically, what age ranges, genders, and interests should you target with your ads? But since we're building a meta ad, honestly, in my experience, Meta's algorithm is better for selecting audiences than anything I can do on my own. So from here, your next step is to jumpstart your ads manager with the creatives and the text copy that you just copied, or to prepare for your own internal approval process if you're a larger organization. Will you trust AI to create your ads? Let me know in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next video.